The Illuminati can be generally difficult to define, so I will stick to the basic facts to keep it as simple as I can for the sake of this presentation. The Illuminati are a secret society founded in 1776 in Bavaria, Germany by a chap called Adam Weishaupt. The word itself, Illuminati, literally means to be illuminated with knowledge, as this knowledge in turn brings light, illuminating an individual. They are deeply occultic in their beliefs and they revel in secret knowledge. Another name for Satan is Lucifer. Lucifer, which literally translates to light bearer, is more likely to be portrayed as a beautiful angel and light giving. It is common amongst the secret societies and occultic beliefs for Lucifer to be considered as the source of everything, but especially of all light and of all knowledge. The Illuminati are 100% Luciferian in their philosophy. They sincerely believe that the serpent or the devil is the good guy in the Genesis account, and that Eve was right to eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, and that when she did become like God. Albert Pike, one of the founding fathers of Freemasonry, was himself a 33 degree Freemason. He was also a top leader in the Knights of the Ku Klux Klan. Pike, being Sovereign Grand Commander of the Scottish Rite, was a devout Luciferian. His famous works, Morals and Dogma, in 1871, is still today considered to be the handbook or study guide for the Scottish Rite within Freemasonry. This is a direct quote from Albert Pike's works, Morals and Dogma. Open quote. Lucifer, the light bearer, strange and mysterious name to give to the spirit of darkness. Lucifer, the son of the morning, is it he who bears the light? Doubt it not. End quote. However, the Bible contradicts this teaching. It exposes Lucifer as being Satan, open quote. And no wonder, for even Satan himself disguises himself as an angel of light, close quote. The esoteric symbol to present Lucifer is traditionally the lightning bolt. This is referencing Jesus' words in Luke chapter 10, verse 18, where he says, quote, and I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven, end quote. It is not confirmed how many people belong to the Illuminati. According to a credible ex-Illuminati member known as Svali, they make up approximately 1% of the population. They consist of 13 bloodlines. That is to say, you are either born into the order or you're not. So if you hear Lady Gaga is the Illuminati, it is unlikely that she is in the bloodline and actually a part of the Illuminati order. It is more likely the case she has been recruited by them to promote their agenda and help them indoctrinate the next generation. Lady Gaga is just one of the many music artists who have openly sold their soul to the industry in exchange for fame and fortune, hence why her debut album is titled The Fame Monster. The 13 bloodlines of the Illuminati make up the world's elite. They are the head of the banking systems. They are the think tanks of the world, the political groups, the educational groups. They own all mainstream media channels, and their main agenda is simple: world domination, commonly called the New World Order. They want one global village of which they control. They see us, the general public, the masses, as nothing more than a bewildered herd or cattle. Their nickname for us, the people, is the sheeple. The Rockefellers are one of the more commonly known Illuminati families, and David Rockefeller, currently the patriarch of the Rockefeller family, is an American banker and philanthropist. Not just any American banker, mind you. He, along with the Rothschilds, another Illuminati bloodline, between these two families own the entire financial banking system and thus solely control the Federal Reserve, the Rockefellers controlling America and the Rothschilds covering the finances and banks in Europe. David Rockefeller is also the founder of the Council of Foreign Relations and the Trilateral Commission. Both of these political groups basically get together to discuss foreign policy and ultimately are responsible for deciding the future of the world, which again and again the same theme emerges, a new world order, and he makes no secret of this. David Rockefeller is quoted in his book Memoirs as saying, quote, some even believe we are part of a secret cabal working against the best interests of the United States, characterizing my family and me as internationalists, and of conspiring with others around the world to build a more integrated global political and economic structure, one world, if you will. If that's the charge, I stand guilty and I'm proud of it. I need to move on, but if you are interested in more information about the New World Order and the Illuminati's agenda, how they plan to achieve world domination, check out the Georgia Guidestones. This is a monument erected in Elbert County, Georgia, which has their agenda engraved in their own words on each side of the four stone slabs in a different language. There are 10 guides, or commandments if you will, openly outlining their intentions, how they intend to reduce the world population over 80% from 7 billion down to just 500 million, and bring about a new one world religion, or universal spirituality. This monument is generally shrouded with mystery, but the engraved tribute found next to it is a big clue. It has inscribed, "Let these be guidestones to an age of reason." The Age of Reason is a book written by Thomas Paine in 1794. Its intent was to destroy the Judeo-Christian beliefs upon which the American Republic was founded. I should issue a warning at this point that this is all pretty disturbing and very serious, and it's very much out there if you want to look further into it. It's all there, hiding in plain sight. Okay, so let's move on and look at the esoteric symbols the Illuminati use to represent themselves and how they are very much present in today's culture. One of the main symbols is the all-seeing eye of Lucifer, which is referencing that we are under constant surveillance. The all-seeing eye of Lucifer is sometimes known as the eye of providence, which is commonly found on the $1 bill. If we take a moment to focus on the dollar bill, you can see a 13-layer pyramid with the capstone disjointed or elevated, and inside the capstone, the all-seeing eye. Numerology is very important amongst the occult and secret societies, and they take it very seriously. It is not a coincidence that this pyramid has 13 layers, or for example, that Madonna walked down 13 steps at the Super Bowl opening. The number 13 in the occult symbolizes rebirth, transformation, or renewal. For example, there are 12 signs in the zodiac that complete a yearly cycle. The next zodiac sign in sequence would be number 13, or number 1, as it becomes a new beginning of the next cycle. New beginnings, or rebirth, are also represented by a phoenix. Bear that in mind in today's culture. When you see the number 13, or phoenixes, the esoteric message conveyed is support for the New World Order. Above the top of the pyramid, written in Latin, are the two words comprised of 13 letters, annuit coeptis. Annuit means to nod, favour, approve, and coeptis means commencement or undertakings. This is referencing the all-seeing eye of Lucifer and literally translates to "he approves of our undertakings." Under the pyramid, written in Latin, are the words novus ordo seclorum, which translates to the new world order. The Roman numerals are 1776, the year of independence that so happens to be the same year Adam Weishaupt officially established the Illuminati Society. The US $1 bill is in fact loaded with esoteric symbols. If you would like to decode all the symbols and understand how it was put together, why and by who, check out this film available for free on YouTube called The Eye of the Phoenix, Secrets of the Dollar Bill. Okay, so moving on, the all-seeing eye, or eye of providence, is traditionally known as the eye of Horus. It's worth taking a moment to look at Horus, as he is frequently referenced in the music and movie industry, as well as in the fashion industry. This quote is taken from the Dictionary of the Occult, open quote, "Horus's father was Osiris, and mother was Isis. He was called Horus, who ruled with two eyes. His right eye was white and represented the sun. His left eye was black and represented the moon. According to the myth, Horus lost his left eye to his evil brother Set, who he fought to avenge Set's murder of Osiris. Set tore out Horus's left eye but lost the fight. The eye was reassembled by magic, by Thoth, the god of writing, the moon and magic. Horus presented his eye to Osiris, who experienced rebirth in the underworld." End quote. One-eye symbolism is everywhere in the fashion and the music industry, and I do mean everywhere.
It's the mystery of iniquity. Said it's the misery of iniquity. Said it's the history of iniquity. Oh, and it all falls down. Yeah. Telling you all, it all falls down. Yeah. Children, eat your bread, little children. Yeah. Eat your bread, cause it all falls down. Can't handle the truth in a courtroom of lies. Purges the jurors, witnesses, spies. Crooked lawyers, false indictments publicized. It's entertainment, the arraignments, the subpoenas. High profile gladiators in bloodthirsty arenas. Enter the dragon, black robe, crooked balance. Souls bought and sold and paroled for 30 talents. Court reporter, catch the circus on the paper. File it in the system, not acknowledged by the maker. Swearing by the Bible, blatantly blasphemous. Publicly perpetrating that in God we trust. Cross-examined by a master manipulator, the faster intimidator, receiving the judge's favor. Deceiving sabers, doing injury to their neighbors. A status, gratis apparatus, and legal waivers. See the bailiff, representing security. Holding the word of God, soliciting perjury. The prosecution, political prostitution. The more money you pay, the further away solution. Legal actors, Babylon's benefactors. Masquerading as the agency for the clients. Hypocritical giants, morally non-compliant, orally armed to do bodily harm, polluted, recruited, and suited judicial charm, and the defense, is it making any sense? Faking the confidence of escaping the consequence that a defendant is dependent on the system, totally void of judgment, purposely made to twist them, emotional victim, blackmailed by the henchmen, framed by intentions, inventions whereby they lynch men. Enter the false witness, slandering the accused, planting the seed, openly showing he's being used to discredit, edit, headed for the alleged, smearing the individual, fearing the unsuspected, expert witness, the paid authority, made a priority to deceive the majority of disinterested peers, dodging duty for years, hating the process, waiting to return to their careers. Do we expect a system made for the elect to possibly judge correct, properly serve and protect? Materially corrupt, spiritually amok, oblivious to the cause, prosperously bankrupt, blindly to the blind, guilty never defined, filthy a swine, a generation pure in its own mind. Legal extortion, blown out of proportion, in vain deceit, the truth is obsolete. Only two positions, victimizer or victim. Both end up in destruction, trusting this crooked system. Mafia with diplomas, keeping us in a coma, trying to own a piece of the American corona. The revolving door, insanity every floor. Skyscraping, paper chasing, what are we working for? Empty traditions, reaching social position, teaching ambition to support the family superstition. When the son of perdition is commander in chief, the standard is thief. Brethren, can we candidly speak? Woe to the men, trusting in the chariots, them leaning on horses. They run their intellectual sources, counterfeit wisdom, creating the illusion of freedom. Confusion consumes them. Every word they speak, it turns them outwardly white. Internally, they absent the light. Them trapped in the night, in bondage to the cane of the night. Under the curse, evil men waxing more worse. Facts in the first, angelic being cast to the earth. It's time for rebirth, burning up the branch and the root. The empty pursuits of every tree bearing the wrong fruit. Turn to me ill, let him who stole no longer steal. Oh Israel, surrender for Jehovah is real. How long will you sleep, troubled by the thoughts that you keep, the idols you heap, causing the destruction you reap. Judgment is come, find it and return to the one. Abandon the flesh, self-interest, broad way to death, pride and greed, hiding, subdividing the seed. The knowledge of good and evil is what caused us to lie, caused us to die. Let your emotions be crucified, renounce all your thoughts, repent and let your mind be retaught. You'll find what you sought was based on a deception you bought, a perception of naught where the majority remains caught. Loving a lie, not realizing an atom or die. Loving a lie, not realizing an atom or die. Loving a lie, not realizing an atom or die. Loving a lie, not realizing and Adam all died. It's the mystery of iniquity. That is the history of iniquity. That is the misery of iniquity. Oh, and it all falls down. I'm telling you all.
Pyramids are another blatant symbol of the Illuminati. There are many levels to the meaning of pyramids. On the first level, they are a tribute to Egyptology. The occult and Egyptology kind of go hand in hand. According to the Bible, Egypt is a symbol of being in spiritual bondage, living in sin, and generally synonymous with caring for the things of this world, such as riches, or indulging in the lusts of the flesh. God was not pleased with the ways of Egypt and the idol worship and pagan practices that were going on there. This is the part in the book of Exodus where God helps Moses lead the Hebrews out of slavery, delivering them from the bondage of being under Pharaoh's rule. Pharaoh represents man's pride and ego, which again links back to Lucifer, who became Satan when he was cast out of heaven for becoming prideful and thinking he could overthrow God. When you see an upside down or inverted pyramid, again, you're looking at an esoteric symbol. The meaning being it represents the female principle or feminine energy. This is because an upside down pyramid is supposed to resemble the shape of a womb. For example, here is an upside down pyramid in a tree on a children's show on CBeebies. Now that we know this is an esoteric symbol of a womb, it is easy to see that the branches on this tree represent ovaries and fallopian tubes, and the door at the base of the trunk symbolizes the vaginal passage. This symbology is of further interest when we find out that this show is called Ra-Ra, the noisy lion, and Ra is another name for Horus, the sun god in Egyptology. On the other hand, when the pyramid is upright, it is symbolic of the male principle, masculine energy, symbolizing the male phallus. The six-point star is in fact the upright pyramid and upside-down pyramid laid over each other. This hexagram is also called the Star of David, but there is no biblical or Jewish evidence that traces this ancient occult symbol with King David of Israel. However, there is evidence that it was used by King Solomon after he turned to pagan gods and the occult later in his life. The six-pointed star is used in ceremonies by magicians and alchemists and is considered a powerful symbol among occultists, and perhaps why the Illuminati ensure that pyramids are prevalent in the music and the fashion industry.
As we move forward, anytime you come closer to something, your vision should get clearer.
Satanic symbols are prevalent in today's culture, but like the Illuminati symbols, more often than not, people are just not aware of what they're looking at. A bog standard satanic symbol is the upward facing 5-point star known as the pentagram. Each of the 5 points represents one of the elements, and this star, inside a circle, is used in satanic practices and witchcraft for summoning demons and ritual sacrifices. These rituals take place within the star, which is within the circle, as they believe that the energy or demons they sum up are attracted to the symbol and when summoned will remain within the circle. Sometimes the 5-point star is inverted with a goat head inside. The goat head is also referred to as the goat of Mendes or the sabbatical goat. In astrology, the 10th sign of the zodiac, Capricorn, is represented by the leaping goat, whose greatest attribute is liberty or rebellion. In tarot cards, the goat card is also known as the Baphomet and is the devil card. Baphomet was first created by the Satanist Eliphas Levi and is considered a satanic deity today. His image is a clear depiction of the occultic theme of duality. This image represents heaven and hell, night and day, male and female. Here you see him as having a human body, which is male from the waist down, having an erect penis, and female from the waist up, having breasts, and topped with a goat's head. With his right hand pointing upwards towards a white crescent moon, and his left hand pointing downwards towards a black crescent moon, occultists are supposed to follow the left-handed path that points downwards towards hell. This again is the opposite to Christianity, where according to the Bible, Jesus is called the right hand of God, And as Christians, we are to follow Jesus, which in doing so leads us upwards towards heaven. We see Lady Gaga often posing as Baphomet, and here quite blatantly. Notice her left eye is closed and she is holding it in her left hand. There is no doubt that this is a tribute to the left eye of Horus that was plucked out. Also notice the white doves that are flying the downward path to hell towards her left hand. Again, this is very provocative imagery, as a white dove in the Bible is a symbol of the Holy Spirit.
You are a tool and a hidden hand is using you. Please don't be delusional. The rulers of this world practice confusing you. The people and the priests and the imams have been jammed by government scams. Mind systematically programmed. Blatant black hatred and racism. The way they lace the whole world and nation with traces of Satanism. This place is a pagan prison. The founding fathers' enslaving intentions were no different than Bush's and Reagan's visions. 1776, it took action. This Illuminati took form and was spawned from a Colombian faction. Just flip your $1 bill over. And if you want me to expose the true code of deception, I will show you. We live in a designed wicked system. The number 13 is consistent in Masonic symbolism. It represents transformation. 12 completes a cycle, so 13 is rebirth and regeneration. The meanings of the symbol are strategically hid. On the left side, you see a 13-layered pyramid. Over that, sits the all-seeing eye where the light shines, a sign of the devil watching over you at all times.
Another important element to mention regarding the principle of duality depicted in the Baphomet image is the occultic saying, as above, so below. This very common occult expression means many things to different people. Some relate it to astrology, that the stars above are a reflection in the events on the earth. Some suggest that it means that God is like man and man is like God. It has also been suggested that these words are an expression of Satan's desire to establish his rule upon the earth as a reflection of his present rule among the fallen angels. Look at the similarities between Britney Spears' advert for her perfume and the great symbol of Solomon. The principle of duality is covertly being communicated. Once you know the reference, it isn't difficult to understand the esoteric message of this perfume campaign. At this point, it might be worth mentioning that in the Message version of the Bible, the part of the Lord's Prayer where it says, "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven," has been rather badly translated as, quote, "as above, so below." The listener can make what they want of that information regarding the integrity of the Message version of the Holy Bible. Lady Gaga's perfume campaign is also worth a mention. It's called Fame and is the first black liquid for perfume that becomes transparent as soon as it's airborne. She insisted she wanted it to be black fluid to celebrate the dark, evil side of fame. The composition of the perfume itself actually contains ingredients used in ancient witchcraft and sex magic rituals. Lady Gaga wanted her perfume to include blood and semen. Open quote. While the perfume was based on the molecular structure of the two substances, it would not smell of them. Close quote. She further explained that the blood element was based on a sample of her own blood molecules to create a, quote, "sense of having me on your skin," end quote. Turn the bottle upside down. Does the gold lid remind you of anything?
Obviously, the new perfume that you're releasing, now we did hear that it's going to smell of blood and semen. Is that true? Will it actually smell like that?
No. Well, let me explain. Actually, the perfume smells like an expensive hooker.
Okay.
But I did use, in terms of the process of creating the perfume, I wanted to extract sort of the feeling and the sense of blood and semen from molecular structures. So that's where that came from. And that is in the perfume, but doesn't smell like it. You just get that sort of the after feeling of sex from the semen, and then the blood is sort of primal. And it was taken out of my own blood sample. So it's like a sense of having me on your skin.
Fantastic. Very creative. Very different.
A common tribute to Baphomet is the horned hand sign. The esoteric meaning to this, put simply, is Hail Satan. Yes, rock stars do it, often with their tongues hanging out, but pretty much everyone and anyone in an influential position are doing it, whether they are collecting awards, caught by the paparazzi, performing on stage, at a political rally, or addressing the crowd. Yes, even the Pope does the horned hand sign. I'm just going to pause for a second, as this begs the question, why is the Pope saying with his hands, Hail Satan? I don't want to upset people here, but the truth needs to be told, and by doing just a little research, it is easy to expose the Vatican as being heavily steeped with paganism and the occult. Let me be clear, I'm not saying that Catholics are Satanists, just like not all churchgoers are Christian. On the contrary, there is no doubt that there are sincere Christians within the Catholic Church who love God. But what I am saying, for the record no less, is that the Vatican per se and the foundations of the Catholic Church as a whole have been merged with pagan traditions and has been riddled with occultic references and symbols from the beginning of its establishment. Anyway, let's move on. Okay, here is another popular hand sign. The exoteric meaning, the external or outward meaning being communicated by this hand sign, is everything is okay. The esoteric meaning to this hand sign is the opposite. It is in fact the 666. The three fingers extended represent that there are three sixes. So why does the Illuminati go to so much effort to hide messages in plain sight and communicate through esoteric symbols? And if we, the general public, do not even understand what we're looking at, then what's the harm anyway? What we don't know won't hurt us, right? Actually, no, that's wrong. There is masses of empirical research that proves we process all these symbols and messages. Every single one is processed on a subconscious level. You see, our conscious mind, which is always busy trying to make meaningful sense of everything we see and hear, is limited as to how much it can process, as too much information would result in overload. However, our subconscious mind is constantly collecting and storing all information, especially that which our conscious mind is unable to process immediately. The word subliminal is defined as existing or operating below the threshold of consciousness, and subliminal messages are specifically designed to influence our mental processes and behaviour. Our society is shaped by our morals and beliefs, and our morals and beliefs are influenced by what we watch, read and hear. What has become acceptable in society today and not given a second thought would have been rated 18 or triple XXX 20 years ago. With a subtle but steady decline in our standards of sex and violence presented by the mass media, in our music, movies, and video games, there is little that shocks or offends us anymore as we are so desensitized. It's a wonder how much exposure to depraved lyrics and images it takes until we feel a sense of moral conviction stimulated within our hearts. Our subconscious is being constantly bombarded from all angles with images of sex, violence, and occult themes and practices. It is through our subconscious state that we are able to absorb all information without resistance, as our brains are in a passive mode and more susceptible. You see, our brains fire different wavelengths depending on what we're doing. For now, we will just take a quick look at alpha and beta brain waves. Alpha waves are associated with relaxed states. It is during this state that the brain is susceptible to suggestibility. Beta waves, on the other hand, are higher active waves and are associated with active logical thought. We are better capable of critically thinking and evaluating when our brains are in beta waves. However, when we switch on the TV and start watching, our brains almost instantly start firing alpha waves. There has been many experiments that demonstrate just how susceptible our subconscious state is, and that prove that what we absorb into our subconscious affects our attitudes and behaviour. Thank you for your time.